creatures of our God and King. Lift up your voices, let them sing. Alleluia, alleluia. Bright burning sun with golden beams, soft silver moon with gentle gleams. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Great rushing winds are moving so strong. Blue clouds above that sail along. Oh, praise Him, alleluia. Fair rising morn with blazing joys. Stars lightly shining, find the voice. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Swift flowing water, pure and clear. Music for the Lord to hear. Alleluia, alleluia. Far so intense with wisdom bright, who gives us through the mountain light. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. By day, unfold your blessings on your way. Oh, praise Him, alleluia. All flowers, fruits, and in you grow. Let them bring them lands and show. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. All you with mercy in your hearts, forgiving others, take your part. Oh, sing now, alleluia. All you can meet is a bear. Praise God, no guest, and into care. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia. And even you, lost mental death, waiting to hush our final breath. Oh, praise Him, alleluia. You lead back home with child of God. For Christ our Lord will win His throne. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Let all things in their aim blessed, worship Him in humbleness. Oh, praise Him, alleluia. Praise God the Father, praise the Son, and praise the Spirit, three in one. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, gathered here this morning, we ask the Lord in His great mercy and love to ease the burden, to dry the tears, to strengthen the hearts of all believers. We pray that this great brother and friend of St. Vincent de Paul already rejoices in the company of his mentor and friend, seeing Jesus, whom they served in the poor, seeing Jesus, whom they served in his people, sharing with Jesus the banquet of eternal life. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of John, your servant and priest, whom you honored with sacred office while he lived in this world, may exult forever in the glorious home of heaven through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I rejoice because they said to me, "We will go up to the house of the Lord." And now we have set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. A city that the Lord has joined fast, unity is yours, O Jerusalem. And to it all of the tribes go up, tribes of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. According to the decree of Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. And in it there are set up judgment seats, seats for the house of David. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Pray for peace in you, Jerusalem. May those who love you prosper and grow. And may peace prevail within your walls, prosperity in your buildings. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Because of friends, relatives, I say, may peace be always with you. Because of this house of the Lord our God, I pray for your good. Let us all rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Even if you have to die, close to my word, keep faithful. For your faithfulness, I will give you the crown of life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life will lose it. And whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. I am troubled now, yet what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? But it was for this purpose that I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Father Rafael, who is the provincial of the Vincentians in New England, is unable to be here this day. He is traveling from Rome. But in his name and in the name of several confreres, and on behalf of the entire Vincentian community of New England, I wish to thank Bishop Labashi, Bishop McCormick, Bishop Christian, the priests and deacons of the Diocese of Manchester, and the people of God from the many communities where Father John lived, where he ministered and served, for gathering this day in prayer to celebrate this Eucharist and to honor Father John, a Vincentian priest. Priests often appear, they show up because they are sent. And sometimes it's good to know a little bit about their background, something of where they have come from, where they have served, where they have ministered. It helps to make them real, flesh them out, so to speak. Father John grew up. And if you're from Connecticut, you hear the word valley. It's the lower Naugatuck Valley, Derby, Seymour, Ansonia. He attended local parochial school, and while he was a young man and attending St. Michael's School, he was once asked a question by a priest who served there. Did you ever think about becoming a priest? It was a question that he took very seriously. And he did enter a minor seminary for the Vincentian, St. Joseph Seminary in Princeton, New Jersey. He later went on to complete his novitiate and finished his philosophical and theological studies at Mary Immaculate Seminary in Northampton, Pennsylvania. He was ordained on May 30th, 1970. His first 8 years as a priest were as an instructor of religion and a teacher of English at St. John Canty Prep, a Vincentian high school that the Vincentian priests and brothers conducted in Erie, Pennsylvania. After 8 years there, he served as a vocation director for our community for 2 years. And then in 1980, he came for the first time to New Hampshire, to the Diocese of Manchester, to Bishop Brady. He was there as a teacher and instructor, and part of his time there was as principal. In 1987, he became the pastor of St. Peter's, and he served there until 1996, when he was selected as the provincial superior, the major superior of the Vincentians in New England. And then in 2006, he returned to the Diocese of Manchester, this time in a very different capacity. He became part of the Office of Continuing Formation for Clergy. And he was also a person who shared in the formation of seminarians, as well as a co-director for the permanent diaconate. And just this past Thursday, the Lord called him home to reward him for his generous service. Today, as we gather, I remember, I regret, and I rejoice. I remember. I am certain that each of you who is present this morning has their own cherished memory or memories of an encounter with Father John. But given to me this morning is the privilege to share memories, experiences of a dear confrere and friend, Father John. I remember him as a man who loved his mother. My first assignment as a priest was in his home parish, and his mother, who had MS, was confined to home. And I enjoyed visiting her regularly, because not only did I get to know her, but I also got some great and profound insights into Father John and came to realize just what she meant to him. I also remember this morning a man who loved to sing and to use his voice in praise of God. And I also remember that whenever I would begin to sing, he would laugh. Oh, Donna. I remember a man who was an avid reader, who always had a book in his hand or at his side. And then he would give it as a gift to someone who would value and appreciate it. I also remember a man who was passionate about golf. The shoes were always clean, the clubs were always washed, and he was ready to play. And he was always looking for that new driver or that iron that might enable him to work another miracle on the links. I also remember him as a man who was enthusiastic about the Yukon women's Husky basketball team. He and I enjoyed watching their games, and this past February 29th, we were able to watch them play their final regular season home game at Gamble Pavilion in Stores. But he loved their teamwork and the way in which they worked together. I remember a man who could size up situations pretty well. Illustration. A number of years ago, we were on vacation together, and Father John loved golf. And he said, come on, you have to go out there and play. And I said, no, I don't think so. You know, I as a young man, had spent time as a greenskeeper. I enjoy watching the game. I said, I don't think so. But he twisted my arm. So I rented a set of clubs and a dozen golf balls. And by the time we got to the ninth hole, I had lost all of my 12 golf balls. He never brought up the topic again. I also remember a man who was kind, a man who wished to make the lives of all whom he met somehow easier, less burdensome. We all know that a person who is kind manifests something about the core of who they are, that they truly yearn from deep inside to be a blessing for another. I remember a man who had a deep commitment to prayer, personal and in community. A man who, I think, deepened the importance and significance of prayer from words of St. Vincent that he oftentimes shared. Give me a man of prayer, and he will be capable of anything. I remember a man who had imprinted on his heart the motto of the Vincentians, he has sent me to bring the gospel, the good news to the poor. He took the word of God very seriously. It was something that he treasured. In preparing a homily, a conference, whatever it might be pertaining to God's word, he would take that word and he would read it. He would reflect on it. He would look at a variety of commentaries. And then he would sit down and longhand write out the entire homily, the entire conference. He had beautiful penmanship. And he would then send it on, and he taught many of his friends to type them. But he took in the word of God. He reflected on it. He really processed it within his heart. And then he began to write that message that he wished to communicate to the people of God. I also remember him as a man of God who wished to share Jesus, to bring him to others, and to get others to be involved in the mission of Jesus. He truly possessed wholeheartedly the vision of St. Vincent de Paul. St. Vincent, in the Common Rules, in his presenting them to the members of the congregation, wanted each confrere to be a person who would continue the mission of Jesus Christ. First, by preaching the gospel to the poor and seeing things from Jesus' point of view and wanting what Jesus wanted for other people to be communicated. Several years ago, Father John celebrated his 40th year of priestly ordination. And after a small reception that we had at St. Peter's, he shared with me a little note that he received from a person who was in attendance. And I kept that because I think it embodies in a very real way this first aspect of St. Vincent's vision to preach to the poor, to see things from Jesus' point of view, and want what Jesus wants for a person. I share with you this morning this note. My dear Father John, words cannot begin to describe how important you are to our family. Over the last 23 years, you have married our children, baptized our grandchildren, and made unforgettable memories, not just being there for a ritual, but making these ceremonies meaningful and faith-filled. On a personal note, as a person who has dealt with shyness all my life, every time you say hello, you make me feel truly valued as a human being. Growing up dirt poor, there have been very few people who have taken the time to look beyond this shyness. You buried my dad, giving him an eloquent service fit for a king. He was a good man with a big heart, and you recognize that with your kind words. I think those words give some insight into why he preached the good news and attempted to do so with the eyes of Jesus and the desire of Jesus to truly do what he wants that word to bring about. But Vincent de Paul had a twofold vision. It was not just preaching the gospel, the good news to the poor, as I mentioned, but St. Vincent de Paul also wanted each of his confreres to be people who knew how significant it was to work with seminarians and priests and to help them grow in knowledge and in virtue. In 2013, Father John completed a term as a trustee at Niagara University, and he was asked on that occasion to give a talk to the university. And the topic he selected was Vincent de Paul and the formation of priests. I'd like to share with you just a few paragraphs of what he spoke. In my own work of clergy formation for the Diocese of Manchester, I tried to bring forward much of what I have learned from Vincent himself. In particular, this means a nose for mission effectiveness, collaboration, flexibility and inventiveness, the unity of prayer and action, a spirituality that transforms humanity, and a linkage between gentleness and compassion. The motivation for my ministry of ongoing formation for priests comes from St. Vincent himself. And he quotes St. Vincent, "How fervently the missionaries must give themselves to you, my Savior, to contribute to the formation of good priests, since it's the most difficult and the most important ministry for the salvation of souls and the advancement of Christianity." Father John carried within him that lesson from Vincent de Paul in his love for seminarians, for priests, and for deacons. I mentioned this morning that I remember, but I regret. I regret that Father John has been taken from us, not because we'll never see him again, but rather because his death diminishes each one of us. Whenever someone we love dies, we too die a little. We know that we can never be exactly the same. An area of our life, an encouraging voice, a familiar footstep, a shoulder to lean on, a simple, meaningful act of kindness has now disappeared, and it can never be created on this side of eternity. A grace has been taken from us. Yes, I remember, I regret, but I also rejoice. I rejoice that I have lived with a friend and a confrere who loved his priesthood, who loved the church, and who loved being a son of St. Vincent de Paul. I rejoice because I was the recipient of a brother's love and could share ministry with him. I rejoice because I witnessed how the love of Jesus as the bread of life strengthens and transforms a person more and more into the one whom we receive. I rejoice because I witnessed how Father John led God's people on a path to greater charity and selflessness. I rejoice because I came to see how generously and graciously a man who loves God's word can truly nourish his people and strengthen them. I rejoice because I saw how a person could be selfless and zealous in being truly concerned about the salvation of other people. I rejoice that Christ said to Father John on February 4th, 1943, the day of his baptism, that you do not belong to death. You belong to me. He was truly a person who valued the great gift that was given to him. On that day of his baptism, he was grafted to Christ, and Christ's life flowed through him, and it continued to flow and to flow until this past Thursday. I rejoice that death is not the end of the human story. It is the middle. The end of the story is resurrection and life, which has no end in Christ our Redeemer. It is natural for us to grieve and to mourn, but I rejoice that we do not despair, because like Father John, we believe that Christ is alive. We believe and we know that Jesus is the resurrection and the life, that he has destroyed death forever. And we rejoice knowing that we shall see Father John again. I mentioned earlier that in 1980, Father John came to the diocese for the first time, and that he left in 1996. At a small farewell in 1996, he spoke words which I think are very appropriate for each of us as we gather here this morning. And when the mortal remains of Father John will leave the Diocese of Manchester. That August night in 1996, Father John spoke these words. So he gets the last word. To my brother priest here tonight, I have felt blessed to be welcomed and accepted so enthusiastically into the priestly fraternity of the Diocese of Manchester. Thank you. But let me say a heartfelt word about what all of you, my beloved friends, have meant to me. I have keenly felt God's presence in my ministry with you. Let me repeat, I have keenly felt God's presence in my ministry with you. With God's help, you have encouraged me to grow as a person and as a Vincentian priest. You have drawn me more deeply and more prayerfully into the mystery of Christ. You have energized my preaching and my service. You have helped me find within myself an understanding heart. And you have befriended me. When friends are together in community, the gospel of Jesus makes more sense, and the community becomes a sacred dwelling, a spiritual home. I'm supposed to be an evangelizer, one who proclaims and lives the good news of Jesus Christ. You have evangelized me, and I have listened and learned. For that grace, I will always be grateful, and I will remember. The Church of Manchester will always be for me my spiritual home. Please pray for me as I promise to do for you. God bless you and keep you in his love. Amen.
In response to that prayer for us, prayed by Father John, let us now pray for him and for all God's people, asking the Lord to indeed gather us under his watchful care.
In baptism, our brother John received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our brother John was nourished at the table of our Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our brother John shared in the priesthood of Jesus Christ, leading God's people in prayer and worship. Bring him into your presence where he will take his place in the heavenly liturgy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother John, they seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother John. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
These and all things we ask in your mercy, O Lord, and we ask that indeed you lift us up with our brother, Father John, to the joyful countenance of your face through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
That my Redeemer lives, what joy the blessed assurance gives. He lives who once was dead. He lives my triumphant from the grave. He lives eternally to save. He lives in majesty above. He lives to guide his church in lives to silence all my fears. He lives to wipe away my tears. He lives to calm my troubled eyes. He lives to bless things to all glory to his name. He lives, my Savior, still the same. What joy his blessed assurance gives. I know that my
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Father John, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered here through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles, Saint Joseph, the glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant, Father John, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to one another the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood, and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise Lift your eyes beyond the hills and see the dawn. There is beautiful mercy in the arms of the Holy One. Go in peace, God be with you. Go in peace, be at rest with the saints and the angels. Now you are free. Go in. See, the Father is waiting with a robe of white, purest white. Go and feast at his table with the bread of life, bread of life. Lift your hearts, rejoice and sing, for you are home. Home at last and forever in the arms of the Holy One. Go in peace, God be with you. Go in peace, be at rest with the saints and the angels. Now you are free. Go in peace. Go in
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father John, your servant and priest, that as you made him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Immediately following the memorial mass, there is a reception, a mercy meal taking place in our parish center, which is that way through the snow, across the parking lot, and you're all invited to join us for a time of fellowship, food, and sharing.
Thank you, Father Vaughn. Before the blessing and dismissal, in a very special way, I want to echo Father Anthony's words of thanks to all of the priests and deacons and all who have come here today, and those who have sung and those who have provided for this very beautiful liturgy. In a very special way, Father Anthony, I want to thank you for the remembering, the brief moment of regret, and the great promise of rejoicing that you spoke of in your words. Thank you so very, very, very much. I think everyone was able to say, yes, amen, amen. Thank you so much as a beloved confrere and friend. I want to also, in a very special way, thank Father Vaughn, a young priest who, though not of incension, when you came to be here and Father John was here, having lived with Father Anthony as confreres, you were able to maintain that Vincentian sense of the very presence of Jesus, the outreach to those in need, the great love for the poor, and the living of the gospel. And I thank you so very much for maintaining that for Father John, because that was so important to him. And in a very special way, for receiving him, as in your arms, he was able to begin to see the unveiling of the mystery of heaven. I thank you so very much for being a brother priest and at heart of Incension for him when he most needed it. And Donna, a very, very great word of gratitude for always providing for him that nourishment and meal and that wonderful sense of home, I think in a very special way. Our Blessed Lady thanks you for taking care of one of her priests. Thank you so very much. And Becky and John, all of those at the Pastoral Center being here today, I thank you so very, very much for the warmth that you allowed him to share with you and the warmth that you returned to him. Now, before we go our separate ways, it is our custom that we sing to our Blessed Lady that anthem, that prayer, which is part of our daily, very, very special moment as we sing.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae, a te suspiramus, gementes efflentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O
be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how